the communication between different people from different cultural backgrounds. And now I feel the closest, and I have more understanding on the different regions. I think now I'm going deeper in the understanding of the different regions, what's happening, what are the strengths, what are the weaknesses. We always say that we have to communicate, and CCIWS is the biggest unknown network, and so on. and we always end up, what is the content of the communication? And I believe, and this is my biggest insight from today, is that these stories what are in the interviews. This is the content what we have to dig out. This is the gold that we have to dig out and put it as a content and communicate it as much as possible. And so somehow we should put these interviews and the whole process what is created in a systemic level, so as that we do it as much as possible.
In the interview from the work camp in Thailand, they were, one of the complaints was about younger volunteers. Mm. But the volunteer was 17, 18 years old,
and they were at the welcome.
Went to a work camp. Mm. So, and they felt the person was not mature enough in order to take responsibility for the work. No, I think we cannot generalize, but they said the age was an element in this case, and they only wanted to go swimming and not that. So I think maybe the early age is important, but with specific programs, adapting our way of working, not just opening up the work camp.
Yeah,
if you put them, a special age. I mean, if you put them to go on a welcome, you should be at a certain age before you can.
In the case of Thailand, I think it has to be over 21, right?
But there was a 17-year-old. So probably not everybody uses the same standards.
My conclusion is that communication is the key to keep the IVS movement alive, and the content of the communication should come from the local communities, and therefore we have to put a lot of effort to keep the local communities and the local hosts close to the network.